Some of you may be having a deja vu right now. So yes, this is in fact an improved shortened version of my first video, as that was unnecessarily longer than it needed to be, but more importantly, it took way too long before getting to the main point. So a very late apology.
To discuss the results of the Autodesk Kickstarter printer assessment, which I did on my new Elegoo Neptune 2 printer. As most new printer owners do, I looked on the SD card, which comes with the printer, in the box to do my first print, which was this little nice Buddha, which came out very, very nice. It's pre-sliced G-code on the SD card.
Before doing the quality assessment, it's a good idea to check the printer's calibration by printing a calibration tower and also a temperature tower to get the right printing temperature for the filament.
I used the well-known 20 by 20 millimeter cube, and this cube should be 20 millimeters in every dimension. So I'll take my calipers and show you the results. First, I measure the X direction. My calipers are set to zero. In X direction, we get 19.97 millimeters. The Y direction, there we get spot on 20 millimeters. In the Z direction, there might be a little problem because I had to change the filament. So I have a little gap here in the top. Don't know if you can see it in the camera. That might add a little bit on top. Let's check the Z direction. 20.14, which is very good as well. After getting this very nice result, I thought, how can I do additional measurements? There's a somewhat standardized test, which is called the Kickstarter Autodesk 3D Printer Assessment, which is available for different print technologies. For FDM printers, I use the FDM version. They suggest printing the test with Ethan PLA Plus filament. I have a spool lying around here, and one should use the standard settings of the slicer. I changed only the printing temperature for the filament, which is set to 200 degrees in the default. To find out the correct temperature, I printed the temperature tower starting from 205 degrees up to 225. I decided to go with 220 degrees. I set the temperature in the slicer. Everything else was left to be the default settings. And what I want to do now is to go through the steps in the assessment protocol and show you the results I got with the printer. I prepared a table where I can record the results. Then in the end, we get the total and can compare the Elegoo Neptune 2's result with other printers. I will put a link to the GitHub page for the benchmark in the comments below. And I also will provide the table so you can do the test on your own. The first test is looking for dimensional accuracy, which is done by measuring these cylinders, which are printed in the test. When I lift the model, you will see that all these little pins fall out. That's a test we have to discuss later. First, dimensional accuracy. We have to measure the cylinders in X and Y direction. So the first cylinder should have a diameter of 25. In Y direction and 24.81 and 24.97. The next cylinder should be 20 millimeters, 19.81 and 19.87. 19.81, 19.87. The third cylinder should be 15 millimeters, 14.82 and 14.97. 14.82, 14.97. Next, we should have 10 millimeters, 9.97 and 10.05. 9.97 for X, 10.05 for Y. The last cylinder, 5 millimeters, 5 and in Y, 509. In X we have 5 spot on, and in Y it's 509. how do we interpret the results? We're building an average of the X and Y measurements. So we get an average error for the measurements in X and an average error for the measurements in Y. And we're building the average of these two, which is 0.092. And the difference between these averages is 0.05. To get a score, we have to look through and see that our overall average error is between 0 and 0.1. We are allowed to record a score of 5. If you get other measurements, then you have to record a score according to your findings. The next test is a fine flow control, which is done by inspecting the long spires on top of the platform. And unfortunately, as you can see, one spire broke when I moved the model, but that's not a problem at all. What we have to do is doing a measurement of the shortest of these spires. So we have around 36.7 for the shortest of the spires. There's no spire shorter than 30 millimeter long, but we have a little bit of stringing, which I can probably get rid of when I print the model with a lower temperature. For the sake of this test, I will record score of 2.5, which we get when we have stringing, but no spire shorter than 30 millimeters, 2.5.
Before getting to the next test, if you have not done already, please give my like button a hit and a comment on my video would be really appreciated.
And now, find negative features, which is about all these pins in the model. The tolerances are decreasing from 0.5 millimeters down to 0.2, and the task is to get these pins out only using your fingers and no tools. And if you get all pins, then your printer gets a nice score of 5 if all pins can be removed. Otherwise, just 4, 3, 2, 1. And if you can't remove any pin, then you don't get a score for that. Here it's a score of 5. That's very nice with another printer of mine. And I think I only got down to 0.3 millimeters there. Next check is the quality of overhangs. The overhangs are checked with this feature, which has overhangs from 45 degrees over 30, 20 to 15 degrees. We have to check the downside and compare the quality. The task here is to check if we have loops which are dropped during print and compare that with the 45 degree overhang. Here we have dropping loops in the 15 degree and 20 degree overhang, but not in the 30 degree and 45 degree. Therefore, we can score 3 points for this test. Next test takes a look at the bridging capabilities. We have several bridges here, very short bridges, and then getting longer up to the longest. The test we have to do here is to look if any of these bridges is touching the below bridge. I'm using a small piece of paper to check that. And if it can move freely, then I know there's no bridge, or the bridge is not touching below. As you can see, we can move a piece of paper in any bridge. Therefore, as a result, no bridge contacts the surface beneath it. That's another 5 points. Next is the resonance in X and Y direction. To check this, we have a scale printed in X direction and also in Y direction. And we have to look for ringing artifacts in the print on both scales to see if they go further than 3 marks from the center. In this case, there's no ringing at all. And therefore, the score is 2.5. Finally, we are getting to the z-axis alignment, which can be checked looking at the long pole here. Here you can see some lines. I'm not sure if it's the case with a misaligned z-axis, probably it's a temperature problem, which goes away when I print the model with temperature. For now, I will score no points. This is if we have visible marks, then we don't get any point. After doing all these inspections, we sum up the scores and get a final score of 23. According to the Kickstarter page, we could have gotten a possible score of 30, which would be the highest, indicating a very well calibrated system. As a reference, they give us a score for Prusa E3, MK3, and for MakerBot Replicator 2. For the Prusa I3, they have a score of 22.5, and for the Replicator, a score of 18. We got a score of 23, and therefore we are in the range of the Prusa I3 MK3 printer with the print quality. And I guess that's very nice for a printer which is sold for less than 150 euros or less than $160. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would really appreciate if you would give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel, check the bell as well. And if you have any comments or questions, put them down in the comment section. Hope to see you soon with a new video.